Praise the Lord. Good morning, Second Chance. Ooh. We have a full house. Praise God. Praise God. Where's Pastor? Pastor, we have a full house. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Why don't you stand with me this morning? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And I want to ask you to do me a favor. Let us give the Lord a round of applause this morning. Come on, I say let's give Jesus. This is a clap offering for Pastor. We can do better than this. Let us give Jesus. Come on, church, Second Chance. Let us give Jesus, the King of Glory. Come on, everybody, clap your hands. Clap your hands. I want to see everybody clapping their hands. Make a joyful unto noise unto the Lord. Clap your hands this morning to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He is here in our midst this morning. And now I want you to lift your hand to heaven this morning. And I want you to begin to worship him. Today is not a day to be somber. Today is not a day to be sad. But today is a day to say thank you, Lord. Thank you for what you did 2,000 years ago. Thank you, God, because of what he did. It is possible that we can come here this morning. And so, God, we come to say thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. We come to say thank you. Thank you that you so loved us. That you so loved us, my God. That you did not give up on the way to the Via Dolorosa. You did not give up even though you fell down. Even though you stumbled under the weight of the cross. My God. Hey, shut up. He took our pains, he took our sickness, he took our diseases, and he nailed it on that cross. And so this morning, God, because of what you did, Lord, we are here today, my God. We are the redeemed of the Lord. And if you are redeemed this morning, the Bible said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hey, if you are redeemed, that says so this morning. You are redeemed from the curses. You are redeemed from the activities of the devil. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes, God. We have the victory. We have the victory. We are more than triumphant. We are more than victorious. We are priests. We are sons and daughters of the Most High God. Oh, Lord. And we bless your name. We celebrate your name. We worship your name. For there is no other name. I said there is no other name. There is no other name but the name of Jesus. There is no other name that the angels bow down to. There is no other name that demons tremble at. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes, my God. And we bless your name. We bless your name. What a wonderful name. What a powerful name. Oh, yes, my God. Oh, how we worship you, Lord. How we worship you, Lord. Mighty is our God. Mighty is our King. Mighty is the Lord. You are the ruler of everything. Hey, Oshayana la Mosaya. Yes, my God. Yes, my God. Because of what you did, Lord, age-long captivity is broken. Because of what you did, my God, age-long sickness, oh God, is broken. The cycles and the patterns, they are broken today. Yokes of bondages are loose today. Oh, Yashatana Mode. Longer, God, do we have to carry? Oh, yes, God, because you are victorious, because you paid the price, because your blood is on our doorposts. Mashada la Mosaya. We know today, God, that when the devil see the blood, when the devil see the blood, he has to pass over. Oh, yes, I am. Apply the blood of pressure. Apply the blood upon your doorposts, the blood upon your mind, the blood of Jesus upon your businesses. Apply the blood upon your sons and your daughters. Apply the blood. Pray in the Holy Ghost for a minute. Rabokoteya, Rebakoteya, Radamosheka, Makatore Masandoi, Rekatore Lamande, Sekotere Rade, Aya, Shakore Radamasaye, Ikoboshande, Ikabara Lamasada, Yantore Lamada, build up your faith by speaking in the Holy Ghost. Raboshe, Mandore Casandoro Boshaya, Pura Mande, Kesatore Lamande, Eyamashira Lamandoya. Yes, Lord, Iraboko Shatara Lababayade. This is the day that our God has made. Oh, Yashayira Labokosa, Mandore Kesandoro Boshaya, Rababayes, Sotoro Boshe, Mandere Kosira. Oh, we praise you, God. We praise you, God. We praise you, Lord. Thank you for the victory, God.
We praise your name. We bless your name today, God. We honor you this morning, God.
We praise you, Jesus.
Come on, one more time all over this place. Could somebody lift a hand to heaven? Yeah, we give you praise today, Lord God. Hallelujah. We bless you, God. We honor you. We worship you. We bless your name, God. Hallelujah. Jesus reigns, he reigns, he reigns, he reigns. Oh, alleluia. Somebody.
Is that love that made
was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. Save me. One day when I was lost, Jesus died on the cross. I know it was the blood. Save me. So kneel at the cross. Christ will lead you there. Somebody. Give him a shout of praise. Hallelujah. We worship you, God.
Yes.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, he lives, he lives, he lives, he lives. All my fears are gone because I know he holds my future. My life is worth a living just because he lives. Come on, somebody, because he lives. He rules, he reigns, he's sovereign, he's God. And we give him all the praise. We give him all the glory. Yeah, we give him all the honor in Jesus' name. You may be seated and welcome. Welcome to Second Chance. We're so glad that you're here. I have to admit, when I came here at 9 a.m., and I said the church was empty, and I said, I wonder if people are going to come this morning, but you came, and I praise God for all of you that we can come together to worship the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Isabel is coming to bless our hearts with a song. Will you make her welcome this morning?
from the darkness into glorious light.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Good morning. Good morning. Welcome. I didn't fall asleep. Oh boy, when you get old, you know, just daydreaming. Pastor is always a one step ahead of me. Every time I try to catch up with him, he just, well, praise the Lord. God bless you. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. It is indeed a pleasure. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
And you know, I have to do this for Brother Antonio. You look better sitting in front. When you walked in, everything changed, and so we have to secure the seat for Brother Antonio. You look wonderful. Praise the Lord. How is everyone doing?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. It's Good Friday, and nothing good but this Friday, but I got to tell you something. I love it. I remember this day more than 2,000 years ago when Jesus laid down his life. They didn't take his life, because no one can take the life of our Lord and Savior. Praise the Lord. If this is your first time, would you just let us know? Any guests for the first time? Could you just do so by, just stand so we can give you a warm welcome. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Glory. Glory. Hallelujah. We trust that this experience will bring you back. There's no place better to be but at Second Chance.
Yes, amen.
Praise the Lord, where the presence of God dwells and where we worship, because we know the God that we worship. He's alive. He's not dead. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank you so much for those watching online. God bless you. Thank you for continued support to this ministry. And we want to thank you for your support week after week and for joining us online. And at this time, I'm going to ask you to stand. And we'll take up today's tithes and offerings.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I'll give you a second to get those big wallets out.
Amen.
And all those weight. Listen, just get all the weight off right now. Here's your opportunity. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. We thank you for your presence here this morning, oh God. We thank you, God, because we know that you are alive. We don't serve just some God, but we serve the one true living God. And so this morning, oh God, as we come together in your presence, we come here as your body, the body of Christ, the bride of Christ. We come to celebrate the death of your son more than 2,000 years ago that birthed our right to come directly to you. And so this morning, as we linger in your presence, we have expectations, oh God, of something great. We have expectations. We came with expectations. We came, God, knowing that the God we serve always delivers. And so as we spend these moments with you, we pray that you manifest yourself in the most mighty way, that your presence would be felt, that your Holy Spirit will find liberty and roam the corridors of this sanctuary and even the corridors of our minds, oh God, as we're fixated on what you're going to do for us today. Heavenly Father, I pray that no one leaves this place the way they came in. If there's anyone with burdens, oh God, they'll leave it here today. If anyone came here in distress, they would find the joy and the peace that you offer, oh God, to those that you have saved. And so this morning, we give you thanks. We thank you this morning for the offering. We pray that you bless it. Bless those, oh God, who have to give, and those who don't, that you would bless them. Open doors for them. Minister into their lives, that their cups will be running over. Their tables would be overflowing, oh God. I pray, oh God, that your people would be lenders and not borrowers. I speak this morning life into dead wallets. I speak life into dead cupboards, oh God, because I know, God, that you are able. And so this morning we thank you. We give you praise, God, and we give you glory and honor. I pray your anointing on your manservant. as he comes to deliver your word, that your word would go forward, oh God, and form root in our lives. Yes. That something new would be deposited into us that would help us to take many more steps on this journey. That we will not look back, God, but we will look forward. Because, oh God, we know there's one day the same Savior that died for us, he is coming back soon. And so we give you praise and glory in Jesus' name.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life.
Come on.
I'm so glad you came to save us. Praise the Lord. Rihanna is coming to bless our hearts with a dance this morning. Will you make her welcome? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord God.
Glory forever I'll and I'll cherish thee, O rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling to the O rugged cross and exchange someday for a crown. Yeah, I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a
God. He's a good God, and we're so glad that you're here this morning. Ray and Amrita, we thank God for you and your family. I know you're living all the way in 209th Street. You're my neighbors, and we praise God for you. Bibi in Pennsylvania, Pennywood Avenue, we're glad that you're here. And Trisha from Pennywood Avenue also, we're glad that you're here. Chrissy is coming all the way from Baldwin. Praise the Lord. Baldwin is in the house. Hallelujah. And Aseline Fenelow, if I mess that up, please forgive me, from Rockaway Park. We praise the Lord. We're glad that you're here. We don't really know you that much, but we've been praying that the Lord will send you. Amen. And to all of you that come here week after week after week, we praise God for you. I still pinch myself sometimes when we see the crowd of people, and we praise God for you. I must admit my lack of faith this morning when I came, and I said, I wonder if people are going to be able to come to church with all that's going on, being so busy, but you made it, and so I praise God for you. You know, it's Friday, it's Good Friday, and like Pastor Keith said, there's nothing really good about Friday, this Friday, except that the Lord Jesus Christ laid down his life for us. And, you know, the cross that we had here, we deliberately had it done, not with all the polished wood and all of that gleaming, but just to let it be rugged, and like the way it probably was that Friday. And we thank God that he has washed us and he's made us white as snow. Amen. He's made us pure. Hallelujah. And so we get to boast in this Lord God Almighty. And so we want to take part in communion this morning. Hallelujah. Nick, thank you there. Praise the Lord. I praise God that when we think of communion, we think of the past, when we always think of the present, and we think of the future. We think of the past because we look back to the cross, and the Bible says that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. We will do good things for someone who is good to us, but we didn't know the Lord Jesus Christ, and yet he died for us. And we think of the past, then we think of the future. And he said, I won't drink of this cup until we meet again. And so one day we have this blessed hope that we will meet with our Lord Jesus Christ. We will see him face to face, and all the struggles and the problems that we've gone through in this world, it'll be worth it when we look at him face to face. And he sees us, and a smile comes on his face. And it reminds us of the present that we share in this relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. We have an intimate relationship where we can come to God the Father. And we come not with shame or with sin. We come knowing that we are clothed and decorated with the glory and the splendor and the majesty of his Son Jesus Christ. Because when the Father looks at us, he no longer sees us as sinners, but he sees us as his sons and his daughters. And I will never ever be worthy enough to partake in communion. There is nothing you and I can do in this life that could earn the right to do this. But we thank God that Jesus paid the price and he purchased us, and now we are sons and daughters of Almighty God. And so before we partake, maybe there's something in your mind, maybe there's something you need to talk with him. Maybe you took some wrong roads on this journey called life, and there's something you need to talk to him about. So right where you are, will you bow your hearts, and very quietly, will you share with the Master, with the Creator, will you let him know where you are, let him know if there's some weaknesses in your life, let him know that you need him to come and to touch you, to wash you, to cleanse you. Father, I thank you, Lord God, I thank you, Father, that when you see me, you see the righteousness of your Son, Jesus Christ, and I praise you, Father, I praise you that I can come in the name of Jesus Christ. Sometimes I don't have the right words to say, I don't know how to, sometimes I can't tell you how I feel in my heart, but I thank you. them today more than any other day. And so as we partake, bless us, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. If you wish to partake, will you please stand? If for whatever reason you choose not to partake, you may be seated. And this is for anyone who is a follower of Jesus Christ. You don't have to belong to this church membership. You just need to belong to the body of Christ to partake. We worship you today. Hallelujah. We praise you. Hallelujah. An awesome God, a mighty God, a great God, the one true God. Who can take your place? Who can challenge you? Who can stand next to you, God? There is no God but you, God. We worship you. We worship you. We thank you for Calvary. We thank you for the cross, oh God. Thank you that you took our shame and our pain, and you paid the price for my sins, God. I'm so grateful and thankful. Thank you, God, that you brought people together, that we can worship you, God. We can praise you and we can bless you. We can celebrate what you did for us on Calvary, God. We praise you, we honor you, and we worship you. Glory to God the Father. Glory to God the Son. Glory to God the Spirit. We honor you, God. We honor the triune God. We praise you, Lord God. We worship you, King of kings and Lord of lords, the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Counselor, the Prince of Peace, the Alpha, the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning, the ending, the author and the perfecter of our faith, His Majesty, the King Christ Jesus. You hold the keys to death and hell. You conquered sin. You rose again, God. There is no one like you, God. No one can boast of a God like you. Hallelujah. You're incomparable. Who can dare challenge you? And so we bless you and we praise you. Shall we partake in this which represents the Lord's body? And shall we partake in this which represents the Lord's blood? And we praise you and we thank you and we honor you. And we worship you. Will you take a moment just to thank him for the cross? Will you take a moment to thank him for his sacrifice? Will you take a moment to thank him for the blood that was shed for our sins? Thank him that we are now children of Almighty God. We praise you. We bless you, God. We honor you. We worship you, God. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen and amen and amen. Praise the Lord. You may be seated, and glory to God. Hallelujah. We welcome back Sabrina. Sabrina has been away for two months, actually. We pray that she doesn't really have any more babies very soon. And it's not a good example. If you're having a baby, we're expecting you here the next week. Amen. Glory to God. And so we'll be showing the picture of this amazing baby. I think I looked at the picture and I said, this baby has nothing from Elaine's side of the family. It has all of our genes. The baby is amazingly good looking. Not that Elaine's family isn't, they're great looking, but we're like so amazingly good looking. But praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You look absolutely amazing. Will you turn to the person next to you and tell him it's good to see you in church? Yeah. Yes, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, I wonder if you were to tell the person next to you, hope to see you tonight. I wonder if you're able to say that with a straight face. I wonder if you're able to say that with a straight face. Hope to see you tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We're going to be here again tomorrow. Tomorrow morning, we give out groceries. Every Saturday at 8 o'clock, we give out groceries in front of the church. And then Sunday morning at 8 and 10. I can't wait for Sunday to be here. Over 2,000 years ago, on a day just like today, a man carried a cross on his shoulders through the narrow, dusty streets of Jerusalem. He hadn't slept. Jesus had been questioned on four different occasions. He was beaten severely, and he had endured about 12 hours of this treatment, and now he carried a cross on this path called the Via Dolorosa, which means the way of suffering. And as he walked through Jerusalem, he was headed to this place called Golgotha, Calvary, just outside the city walls. Imagine that just a week ago, less than a week ago, these same people, They had welcomed Jesus, shouting, "Hosanna, Hosanna!" And they were laying their clothes on the ground so that the donkey could ride through into Jerusalem. Now some of those same people were crying, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" They didn't know that this poor carpenter boy, who had never traveled further than 50 miles from his home, was born so that he could die. We were born to live. Jesus was born to die. And they never thought that he would change the world forever. They never imagined that he would be followed by hundreds of millions of people around the world, even to this day. And so the beauty of heaven carried our shame all the way to Calvary, where the Creator was crucified by his own creation. The same people that he breathed life to, the same people that he allowed to walk on the dusty paths of this planet, the same people he gave his sunlight and rain to, crucified him. And this happened over 2,000 years ago, but I just want to let you know very, very quickly this morning that the blood still has power. Amen. Come on, I don't know if you heard me, but I said the blood still has power. The blood of Jesus still washes away sin, somebody. Through this blood, anyone can become a son or daughter of Almighty God. It doesn't matter what you lived before. Anyone through this blood can come to Jesus. There's still forgiveness in the blood. There's still power. There's still life flowing through the blood. It will never, ever lose its power, somebody. The blood. And you know, we live in a modern world today with its rapidly evolving technological advances and breakthroughs. And many wonder if the cross is still relevant, if the cross still has a message, if it's still applicable to us today. Is there still a message from the old cross? Our scripture this morning is Matthew chapter 27, verses 27 through 33.
Then the governor's soldiers took Jesus into the praetorium and gathered the whole company of soldiers around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and then twisted together a crown of thorns and set it on his head. They put a staff in his right hand. Then they knelt in front of him and mocked him. "Hail, King of the Jews," they said. They spit on him and took the staff and struck him on the head again and again. After they had mocked him, they took off the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him. As they were going out, they met a man from Cyrene named Simon, and they forced him to carry the cross. They came to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull.
Father, we thank you this morning. We thank you so much for your presence in this place. We thank you that wherever we're gathered and we call upon your name, you show up instantly. You're not some God far away, but you're personal, you're intimate, you're close, you live in us. And so we're so grateful for your presence. We're so thankful that you who flung the stars into space, you're right here on 121-13 Sutphin Boulevard. God, you are such an awesome God, and we praise you for your presence. During the worship, we sense your presence. Holy Ghost, we felt you. We knew that you were here, God. And now as we prepare your word, God, may you speak to the hearts of your people. May every word, God, this morning resonate in our hearts, oh God. God, may we hear not a man, but may we hear from the voice of Almighty God himself. Speak to us this day. Give us words of life. Encourage us. Inspire us. Many come today with burdens and with crises and with struggles, God. May you meet with them even as your word is ministered, God. May you touch them. Holy Ghost, may you walk down the aisle. May you walk between the chairs and touch hearts and touch lives. Oh, God, some need an extra special touch from you this morning. Whatever they're going through, God, we know that you never fail. You never disappoint. And so we trust you and we believe you. Touch feeble lips of clay one more time. And I promise you, you will get all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, and God's people say, amen. The cross still speaks of pain. You know, Jesus was badly mistreated in his last few hours on this planet. The Romans, they used a whip called a flagrum. It had small pieces of bones and metals attached to the end, to the strand. So during the flogging, the skin is ripped from the back, exposing tissue
and bone, and there's severe loss of blood, and so a person loses consciousness very, very quickly. And Jesus was beaten, he was tormented by Roman soldiers. They had plucked his beard, and they had pierced his scalp with a crown of thorns. And after the flogging, he had to carry his own crossbar to the execution site, and this alone weighed more about 100 or more pounds. And then 7-inch long spikes were driven into his wrist, and as they lifted up the cross, the strain would normally cause the shoulders to dislocate, and the position of the body on the cross makes it difficult to exhale and impossible to take a full breath. Ladies and gentlemen, the message from the cross was of pain back then, and today the cross still has a message of pain. Every day on this life can be so painful. We go to bed not knowing what tomorrow brings. Today we may be in perfect health walking on top of the mountain. Tomorrow we could end up in a hospital or even in a coffin. There are people going through struggle after struggle. Some have a report from the doctor and it's not a good report. And seems like every time God opens a wide door in front of us, the devil shuts the door in our face. Sometimes like the three Hebrew boys, we seem to go through fire. Or like with Daniel, we seem to be with him in the lion's den. Matthew 27, 32 says, they met a man from Cyrene named Simon, and they forced him to carry the cross, just as Simon back then carried the cross. Ladies and gentlemen, each one of us, we must carry the cross. Early in Matthew 16, Jesus had said to his disciples, he said, if anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily and follow me. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake shall find it. He said, for what does it profit a man if he would gain the whole world yet lose his own soul? The message of the cross 2,000 years ago was a message of pain, and the message is still of pain today. Every follower of Jesus Christ has a cross to carry. You know, you can search from Genesis all the way to the book of Revelation. You can search in every English translation of the Bible, and you will never read that Jesus said, take up your bed and follow me. The bed speaks of comfort, and it speaks of convenience, and it speaks of rest. And you know, sometimes people come to Jesus and they believe that it's a magic wand that is waved and all is perfectly well. You know, we have the perfect family and we have the perfect house and we have the perfect job and we have perfect health and everything is perfect. But Jesus never promised that this life was going to be easy, my friends. In fact, quite the opposite. He said in John 16, 33, in this godless world, you will continue to experience difficulties. And if you check through history, being a Christian was never easy. Early Christians were put to death in some horrible way. Some were put to death in the arena. Many were eaten by wild beasts. Many were killed painfully. Do you know that of the original 12 disciples, it's believed that 10 of them died as martyrs? Paul, think about Paul. He was flogged 5 times. He was beaten with rods 3 times, shipwrecked 3 times, stoned and left for dead, attacked by robbers, executed as a martyr. Yet this same Paul wrote in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, he said, we're hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed. He said, perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed. Yes, being a Christian was never easy. And it never is. But you know something, persecution never stopped the church. Did you know that the church actually grew under persecution? Maybe we need a little bit of persecution here in America and the church would grow. Anywhere you see there's persecution, nothing can stop the church from going. Nothing can. Jesus said, I will build my church. He said, nothing, no one, not even the gates of hell shall prevail against this. But each one of us, we have a cross to carry. You're going to face trials, my friends. Yeah, you're going to face persecutions. You're going to face struggles. And let me tell you, sometimes the intensity of the trials, Peter calls them fiery darts, will surprise us. And sometimes the source of our trials will surprise us, because the source of our trials can be our friends. Amen? Sometimes the very people you think are your friends are the people waiting just for you to turn around to stab you in the back. Sometimes you don't even turn around and they're already stabbing you. And sometimes the source of our trials can come from our very own brothers and sisters. Yeah, I said it. You think sometimes that the fiery darts come on the outside, but they're sometimes right inside waiting to hit us. Remember, friends, in the book of Mark, Jesus told the disciples that they were going to be persecuted by religious people. In fact, Jesus himself was crucified by religious people. So don't think it's strange when you're hurt and when you're criticized by people. The point is that as Christians, we can't be surprised by trials. We should actually expect them. But we thank God that Jesus said in Matthew 6, "Therefore I tell you," he said, "do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear." He said, "Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothes?" Then he said, "Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them." He said, "Are you not much more valuable than they?" So I need to tell you this Good Friday that you are valuable in the eyes of Almighty God. I don't know if you heard that. I said you are valuable in the eyes of Almighty God. Listen, when everything falls apart, hold on to Jesus, because he loves you with an everlasting supernatural love. I know what I'm talking about. I'm not exempted from struggles and pains and trials. I don't live in a bubble as a pastor. This road, that's not an easy road. It's a painful road, but I need to let you know that Jesus is walking with you. Wherever you go on this road, he's with you. He said, "I'll never leave you." He said, "I'll never forsake you." He said, "Wherever you are on this planet, he will always be." He said, "Lo, I am with you even to the end." Many of you sitting right here watching me, you can testify that you've gone through some tough roads. You've walked some rugged roads, but you made it through. Amen, somebody. Some of you watching us, yeah, the devil came at you, but God always brought you through. I want you to let you know, when it seems that the devil has the upper hand, God is still fighting for you. God is still on top, somebody. And so the cross still has a message of pain. Well, everyone will have to carry his own cross, her own cross. The cross also has a message of purpose. In 1 Peter chapter 3, it says, "For Christ also suffered once for sins, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring us to God." See, the message of the cross is not just of pain and suffering, but it also shows purpose. You know, Jesus defeated death. He rose on the third day, reigning victorious over sin. And so trials come, but often these trials, they have purpose behind them. These fiery darts, they come to test us, because the Lord will graciously send them our way to refine us and to prepare us for his coming. Think about it. If you didn't go through that struggle, would you be fasting and praying and seeking God the way you have been? And so many times these struggles, these trials, they come, they have purpose. They come to refine us, to prepare us. Jesus conquered sin and death, and because he conquered, we are more than conquerors. And so even as we go through these struggles, we know that God has he has something behind the scenes, that whatever the enemy meant for evil, he's always turning it around for our good and for his glory. So take heart. Jesus won the victory, and you are going to win. Amen. Jesus rose again, and because he lives, you live also. Don't give up on things just yet. My brother, my sister, dad, mom, don't give up on your family. Don't give up on your son or your daughter just yet. Listen, whatever the enemy meant for evil, God has a track record of always turning it around for your good and for his glory. Psalm 121 says, "I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From whence comes my help?" Where does our help come from? It comes from the creator of the heavens and the earth. In John 16, Jesus said, "I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace." He said, "In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart. I have overcome the world." So my brother, my sister, Jesus won. And because he won, we will always be winners. He has never lost a battle, and he's fighting for you. So whatever pain you may be going through, I need to remind you that there's great purpose behind it. And when God brings you through and you look back, you will say, God, I thank you that you brought me through. He's molding you and shaping you to be, to look just like his son, Jesus Christ. So that you will, when you come through your struggles, you will look like him, you will love like him, you will talk like him, you will forgive like him, you'll even drive like him. Remember what Joseph said to his brothers in Genesis 50? He said, you meant it for evil. You intended to harm me. But God intended it for good to accomplish his purpose. So hang in there, my brother, my sister. Hang in there. Hang in just a moment longer. God is going to bring you through. Amen, somebody. I know what I'm talking about. He who commands the universe is on your side. And you will always win because he's for you. Amen, somebody. Whatever he's allowing you to go through right now, he has great purpose behind it. The cross still has a message of purpose. And the cross has a message of promise. In Luke 23, one of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at Jesus. Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us. But the other criminal said, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And Jesus answered him, truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise. You know, on the cross, the most beautiful exchange, the most amazing exchange took place. Jesus exchanged his perfect righteousness for my sins. He traded his life for my offenses, for my redemption. He broke the curse of my condition to bring me freedom. He took the punishment and the pain to bring me peace. And so his death was traded for my life, for your life. What a beautiful exchange. It's an uneven exchange, but it's a beautiful one. He took the cross. He carried the weight of the world upon his shoulders so that we might be free. You know, this creator, this Jesus Christ, didn't fight against the people that he had breathed life to. He didn't lift a hand against them. Instead, he laid down his life to save the very people that were crucifying him. Jesus Christ, the sinless Son of God, the fulfillment of God's promise to send a Savior to redeem us from our sins. 2 Peter 1, Jesus has given us his very great and precious promises that through them you may participate in the divine nature. Jeremiah 29, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and to give you a future. The promises of Jesus are amazing. They're magnificent. I mean, the promises of Jesus are so precious. When you read about the promises of Almighty God, it just brings peace over your life. And I've got some good news for you, especially if you live in a small apartment that's infested by roaches or you're living in a basement apartment. Jesus said, he made the ultimate promise. He said in John 14, don't let your hearts be troubled. He said, in my Father's house, many mansions. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, he said, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. You see, when we really mature in Christ, when we begin to understand that a Christian no longer lives for himself or herself, but lives for Jesus, our whole perspective on life starts to change. It's only as we mature in our faith, then our real home starts to become a reality in our hearts. You see, the fact is, ladies and gentlemen, as we take up our cross and follow Jesus, we begin to feel a yearning and a burning in our hearts for a true home. Have you ever been in a crowd of 500 people, yet for a moment you felt lonely? A brief moment, you could be in a crowd of people because, you know, we're in this world, but we're not of this world. Our true home is heaven. We were created with eternity in mind, and as long as we're on this planet, we will always miss our true home. Paul said in Philippians, our citizenship is in heaven, and we eagerly await a Savior from there, the Lord Jesus Christ. I tell you, no laws, no government can take that promises away from us. We are citizens of heaven, and our visa is sealed with the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We're heaven bound. Somebody, this world is not our home. We're just a passing through. Just for a moment we're here and then we're gone. Somebody, so listen, Jesus knows that there are times that we're going to be weak and discouraged. And so he's given us this amazing promise of his return. The promise of a heavenly home of great rewards. In Mark 10, Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, no one who has left home or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or fields for me and the gospel will fail to receive 100 times as much in this present age and in the age to come eternal life." So hang in there, my brothers. Hang in there, my sisters. Weeping may come for a night, but joy comes in the morning. The cross still has a relevant message for each one of us. Yes, it has a message of pain and suffering, but it also has a message of purpose. Amen. And it, praise God, it has a message of promise. You know, when you blow kisses at someone, it's a sign of endearment when you blow kisses. You know, when God the Father sent his Son on Calvary, he was blowing kisses at us. The Bible says, "He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him for us all, what would God not do for you?" Love in action. I must admit that after 38 years of serving God, Pastor Keith, I still don't get this unconditional love. I can't understand why God would love a sinner. I still don't get this agape, this sacrificial, unending, this love. I don't get it, but I'm so grateful for it. See, from the point where Adam and Eve sinned, literally millions of animals were slain to make an appeasement for man's sins. But these animal sacrifices never took away our sins. It only postponed it until the next sacrifice and the next sacrifice. But I'm so thankful that Jesus came to restore us back to our precious state. Lambs and goats and doves couldn't do this. Only someone perfect could. And that's Jesus Christ, somebody. You see, man couldn't become God, but God could become man, and Jesus was able to make the payment for our sins. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and he was with God in the beginning. Through him were all things made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In these verses, John established that Jesus was co-eternal, co-existent, co-equal with the Father, and we see that Jesus was responsible for creation. But then later in John chapter 1, a contrast appears. The one who was the creator became the created. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. You see, before there could ever be a cross, Jesus had to first become like us. He became like us so that we in turn could be like him. Have you thought about it? He became like us so that we can be like him. You know, I think about it. Blood always stains. If there's a criminal scene, one of the hardest things to get rid of is blood. Blood always stains, yet the blood of Jesus Christ washes us, cleanses us, and he makes us brand new. Satan, no matter how hard he tries, cannot get around the blood. So if you've sinned, or you've failed, or you've messed up badly, I want to remind you that the blood is still flowing from Calvary, and it'll clean you up and it'll make you fit to be a son or a daughter. It doesn't matter what people will point their finger and tell you, the blood of Christ is able to do it. So on this Good Friday, let me ask you, is the cross you're carrying too heavy for you this morning? Sometimes the burdens that we carry are too heavy for us to bear. That's why Jesus said to cast our cares unto him. Let me ask you on this Good Friday, have you seen purpose in some of the pains that you're going through? And are you excited for the promise that he has over your life? You know, for some of us, eternity might be a little bit closer than you think. You know, I don't want to guilt trip you or put the fear of God in your life, but I just want to let you know that when you leave this place, who knows if we're going to see each other again tomorrow. I don't know the formula that God chooses to call people home. When I was younger, I thought you had to be old to be called home. But I've attended funerals for people in their 20s, so I don't know the formula anymore. So before you leave here today, will you let the message of the cross speak to your heart? Will you bow your hearts with me and let's pray? Bow your hearts. You know, if there's anyone here this morning, you're saying, "Pastor, I don't know this Jesus, but I surely would like to let him into my life." If there's anyone here, anyone, you're saying, "Pastor, I've done some terrible stuff, And I'm not really sure if he's able to do this. Yes, his blood is able to cleanse us and to wash us. If there's anyone here, maybe you grew up as a Sunday school boy or girl, and maybe you've drifted away, maybe family got in the way, or life got in the way, your career, whatever. The cross is still there. The blood is still flowing. If you're here and you're saying, Pastor, will you lead me in this? I want to lead you in this prayer. Will you say, Pastor, lead me in this sinner's prayer? Right where you are. Right where you are. Listen, you don't have to do anything else. You don't have to. Everything has been done for you already. The price has been paid. Right where you are. If you're saying, Pastor, I want to say this prayer. I'm going to say this prayer. And if you're sitting next to someone, will you just say the prayer so that they can hear it and encourage them? Will you say, Heavenly Father, I come before you today as a sinner, but I know that Jesus died for me. His blood still has power to wash, to cleanse, to set me free. So I repent of my sins. I believe in you, Jesus. Forgive me, cleanse me, wash me, make me your child today. And Father, I promise to live for you and serve you until I see you face to face. I give my life to you in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you this morning. Listen, if you said that prayer, you are a child of Almighty God. You may not feel the hairs on the back of your neck raise up or the earth beneath you shake, but I'm telling you, the word of God declares that you're a child of God. And I thank you this morning, God. I praise you for everyone is in our midst today. I pray that you will touch them, that you will bless them, that you will meet every need in their life. Listen, if there's anyone this morning, right where you're sitting, and you're saying, Pastor, I'm going through some stuff, and the burdens that I'm carrying, I really need the Lord to minister to me, to speak to me. So you're saying, Pastor, I need some divine help. Listen, right where you are, you don't even have to stand, but if you wish to stand, just so I can see who I'm praying for, right where you are, no one needs to come to the front, but you're saying, Pastor, remember me in prayer this morning. I want to pray with you. Anyone, just stand up right where you are, and I'll pray for you this morning. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I... Thank you, I see those standing up. I appreciate it. Oh, I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you the only way I know how, God. God, I thank you that you have saved us, you have washed us, and you are with us. You said, God, that you will never leave us nor forsake us. God, you see my brothers and my sisters as they stand this morning, God. If there was ever a time that they needed you, God, it is today, God. And so, Father, you who flung the stars into space, you who said, let there be, and there was, God. We're asking you this morning to intervene, God, in every person standing up, in every family that they represent. God, you know their needs. I don't, but you know it, God. Even before they said it, you knew it, God. And so even as you see their faith in you this morning, God, you see their faith as they stood up, God. I pray, God, that you will touch them. I pray, God, that you will bring healing, God, that you will comfort their hearts, God, that you will minister to whatever the crisis is, God, that you will turn it around, God, whatever the enemy has placed in front of them, God, that you will remove it. My God, that you will be by their side. For those that are weary, that you will walk with them, and those that can't carry on any longer, that you will lift them up and take them over to victory. We thank you, God, that you are always with us, God. You are always, you said, to cast our cares upon you because you care for us. You said, God, that to trust in you with all our hearts and to lean not on our own understanding. So we're throwing your word back at you, God, this morning, that you will show up, oh God, and that you will move mountains on their behalf, that you will tear down walls, God, that their breakthrough will come, that their miracles will come, God. There is no one else we can run to, God. What will the other people say if you don't do it for your people? And so for your name's sake this morning, we thank you. And we praise you, God. From this moment, God, we're only going to declare victory because we know that you are victorious. We are also victorious because you're one. We are winners because you overcame. We are overcomers. And so we praise you for what you've done and we worship you for what you're yet about to do in the hearts and the lives of your people. So I thank you this morning, God. Thank you for every person that came into this building, God. I praise you for them, God, that you will honor their faithfulness, God, to take this time to come. And God, may you bless them. May you bless their household. Will you lift your hands so that I can pronounce a blessing over your name? God, this morning, I proclaim a shepherd's blessing over their lives, God, that you will touch them, God, that you will minister to them, God, that you will move in their families, God. My God, that you will, oh God, open doors for them. Every door, God, that you will open it wide for them, that you will bless them, God. Bless them as they leave this place. Bless them as they leave their homes, as they come back and you set the footsteps of a righteous person. They're ordered by the Lord. So order their footsteps and bless your people, my God. So we give you all the praise. We give you all the thanks. And we worship you. We give you glory, God. We bless your name. We praise you. We adore you. We thank you because you are our God and we are your people. And we give you glory today. Thank you for the cross. Thank you for Calvary. Thank you for paying the price for my sins. Even as we leave this place, God, may we never leave your presence. We give you glory in Jesus' mighty name. And God's people say, somebody clap your hands and bless the Lord. We love you. We're going to be back here at 7:30. God bless you. Praise ye the Lord. God bless you. God bless you.